नियतिकृतनियमरहितां श्लादेकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. वि आर् एट् वाक्यमात्रदोष हतवृत्तं वि आर् डूयिङ्ग् एण्ड् ऐ हेड् टु स्टाप् इन् द मिडल्. सो वि लुक्ड् एट् यतिभङ्गात् वर्णवृत्ते अश्रव्यम् अश्रव्यम् अप्राप्तगुरुभाव अन्तलघु एण्ड् देन् द थर्ड् वन् वास् रस अननुगुणम्. In that Ashravyam, we saw two examples. One was in Harini Vrittam and the other was in Gatha Chandas. Both had, one was because of Yatibhanga. The second was Gana Vishesha Yogat because of the two gurus were inside the shloka and that's why it was a problem. The Aprapta Guru Bhava Anta Laghu, we are there. And the first example we saw was in an Ardha Samavrittam, which was the Pushpitagra Vrittam. Where the Anta Laghu in a meter is considered as Guru, but in the first Pada, when there is a continuation of it in the second Pada, the Anta Laghu is, it's very difficult to get the Guru Bhavam if it is still in that Laghu. That was a problem we saw in the Pushpitagra Vrittam, which was an Ardha Samavrittam. Now we go on to the Samavrittam. This is a Shardura Vikriditam. अन्यास्ता गुणरत्नरोहणभुवः धन्या मृदन्यैव सा सम्भाराः खलु ते अन्य एव विधिना यैरेष सृष्टो युवा श्रीमत्कान्तिजुषां द्विषां करतलात् स्त्रीणां नितम्बस्थलात् दृष्टे यत्र पतन्ति मूढमनसाम् अस्त्राणि वस्त्राणि च. इन् दिस् द मीनिङ्ग् आफ् द श्लोक गोस् दिस् वे. सो विधिना यैः एषः युवा सृष्टः, विधिना एषः युवा सृष्टः. दिस् यूथ् दट् ऐ सी इन् फ्रण्ट् आफ् मी मे बि अ किङ्ग् आर् अ यङ्ग् मेन् हू इस् इन् हिस् यूथ्, सम् वन् इस् लुकिङ्ग् एट् हिम् एण्ड् सेयिङ्ग् इट्स् एक्चुलि इट् शुड् बि अ किङ्ग् आर् अ युवराजा बिकास् बोत् हीस् टाकिङ्ग् आफ् द्विषाम् एण्ड् स्त्रीणां, बोत् दि एनिमीस् एण्ड् द लेडीस्. सो विधिना ब्रह्मणा यैः सम्भारैः एषः युवा सृष्टः. He takes a lot of samagri and he uses those samagri to create this yuva, and this person who is looking at that youth is wondering what are the things that Brahma used to, you know, create such a personality. अन्यास्ताः गुणरत्नरोहणभुवः, the qualities that this person has, the good qualities like dakshinyam, daya, etc., etc., all the nayaka gunas. So guna ratna, those gunas he has to take from somewhere and put it in this yuva when he is doing that srishti creation. That gunam is like ratnam. He is talking, he's saying, he's actually surprised by, you know, what could be the utpatti sthanam for all these gunas, from where he has taken these. So these guna ratna rohana bhuvaha, the bhumi, the pradesham where these gunas have come about, have been created, that is anyaha eva. It's completely different from what he uses for the regular people. Mrit sa mrit dhanya sa mrit anya eva. To create, he has to have a karanam, which is your upadana karanam. That is mrit, some mud he must have used, just like a potter. He is imagining how a potter uses a ball of clay and makes a pot. In the same manner, he is thinking the mud with which mrit, the mud with which he was made, is dhanya. It is indeed fortunate, and anyasa. It's completely different from what he uses for other people. सम्भाराः खलु ते अन्ये एव, ते सम्भाराः अन्ये एव, एण्ड् दोस् सामग्री वस्तूनि दे आर् आल्सो अन्यानि एव, दे आर् कम्प्लीट्लि डिफरेण्ट् फ्रम् वाट् यूसस् रेग्युलर्लि. सो वाट् इस् द वै डस् हि से दट् द विधि हेस् यूस्ड् कम्प्लीट्लि डिफरेण्ट् डिफरेण्ट् क्वालिटीस् विच् हि डजन् यूस् फर् रेग्युलर् पीपल्? बिकास् हि सेस् यत्र दृष्टे यस्मिन् दृष्टे सति, the moment someone sees this person, this yuva, he is so beautiful, one, or handsome, and the other part is he is also prakashayuktaha gunayuktaha cha. tasmat यत्र दृष्टे सति श्रीमत् कान्तिजुषां द्विषां करतलात् अस्त्राणि पतन्ति, मूढमनसां स्त्रीणां नितम्बस्थलात् वस्त्राणि पतन्ति च. अद हियर् श्रीमत् कान्तिजुषां द्विषां इस् एन् एड्जेक्टिव् देर्. सो फार् द एनिमीस् from the hands of the enemies, karatalat, from the hand of dvisham, enemies who are shrimat kanti jusham, they are kanti jusha, they have a prakash swarupa which is also shrimat, very beautiful, and bravery. They are even if they are extremely brave, the enemies, from the enemies hand, astrani patanti, the weapons are all falling down. Moodha manasam streenam, mohita manasam, not you can't say moodha as fools, you take it as confounded. They're totally mohitaha saundaryena mohitaha striyaha tesham nitambastalat tasam nitambastalat, from their waist vastrani, they automatically fall down. In the sense, they don't even notice what is happening to themselves. They are not aware when they look at this. And Saundaralari uses naram varshiyamsam nayana virasam narmasu jadam tava apangaloke patita manudhavanti shatashaha galadveni bandhaha kuchakalasha vistrasta suchayo hathat trutyatkanchyo vigalita dukula yuvatayaha. Vigalita dukula yuvatayaha yasya yasmin ambayaha katakshaha patati. So naram varshiyamsam, even if he is an old person, the moment her grace falls on him, and women just follow him like anything, they don't even know what is happening to them, they are not aware of it. It's all because of her grace. So that apart here, you know, it's a very similar idea which came to my mind. So drishte yatra patanti moodhamanasam streenam nitambastalat vastrani shrimat kanti jusham dvisham cha astrani patanti. Here chardula vikriditam is the chandasya, the lakshanam is surya shvaihi masajas tata sa guravaha chardula vikriditam ma sa ja sa ta ta, those are the ganas that have to be used there. Sa guravaha, along with a guru at the end. Now, because of vapadante, again in chanda shastram we know that the anta laghu varna is always used, considered, can be considered as a guru. Now even though the gurutva bhavam, gurutvam can be considered, but it doesn't give that let's say guru bhavam, or it does not give that tightness, that vritta dardhyam that is necessary there. So if you look at it, strinam nitambastalat or yairesha srishto yuva, whereas here astrani vastrani cha, that cha becomes a instead of that he suggests if you use astrani vastranyapi, then that samyuktakshara before gives a guru bhavam even though it is a laghu at the end. It gives a more tightness to the vrittam when you recite. So mridanyaivasa or srishto yuva, all those places you have the guru at the end, that is fine. Whereas if you look at the last line, drishte yatra patanti moodha manasam astrani vastrani cha, that portion vastrani cha doesn't give that tightness to the vrittam. So you can say drishte yatra patanti moodha manasam astrani vastranyapi, then that gives a nice tone and nice end to the meter. The more if you look at many Shardula Vikriditam shlokas, you will find that mostly it is the kavi, it reflects on the kavi's capability of creating a shlokam in that meter. Because he is not able to do it properly, and that is why that immediately induces a vairasyam in the minds of the reader. Most you can take up many Shardula Vikriditam shlokam, even Naldasas Namam, the Dhyana shlokam is Shardula Vikriditam. What is that? Sindura Trinayana Manik
Sindura Vigraham.
That is also Shardula Vikriditam. Sindura Aruna Vigraham Trinayanam Manikya Modis Purap तारानायक शेखरां स्मितमुखीम् आपीन वक्षोरुहां पाणिभ्याम् अलिपूर्ण रत्न चषकं रक्तोत्पलं बिभ्रतीं everywhere if you see it ends in a guru, right? Three, totpalam bibhratim saumyam ratna ghatastha rakta charanam dhyaye param ambikam. It ends in that guru. Mostly it will end with a guru. Even if it doesn't end with a guru and it ends in a lagu, it is better if this portion, if it was preceded by that vastranyapi, by the samyuktakshara, which will make it more tight. Now the next one, after the aprapta guru bhava anta lagu, we look at rasa anugunam, rasa ananugunam. Rasa ananugunam is a very interesting thing. He talks in detail later also, I think in the 8th Ullasa or somewhere, he talks about the meters that are anugunam for particular rasa. In fact, even in Natya Shastram, he mentions, yadvire kirtitam chandaha tad raudre api prayojayet sheshanam artha yogena chandah karyam prayoktruvihi. Someone should look at the way the meter goes, the trend of the meter, the rhythm of the meter, and see whether it will fit that particular bhavam or rasam. It's very important. So here, the example he gives, he nripa ha buddha, ha nripa ha buddha ha kavibandho vipra sahasra samashraya deva mugdha vidagdha sabhantara ratna kvasi gataha kvavayam cha tavaite. The background here, prakaranam, is a king is no more, and someone who is feeling the loss of that king is speaking about that king in a karuna rasa purva. The meaning is han ripa, each one is sambodhana, so he's saying he's an intelligent one. Kavi bandho, you are like the only relative for kavi. Vipra sahasra samashraya, samashraya, you are the refuge, sharanagati, for vipra sahasra, for thousands of Brahmins, O Deva. Mugdha vidagdha sabhantara ratna, you can split it into separate sambodhanas also. Mugdha sundara, vidagdha intelligent person, sabhantara sabhayam ratnaha, ratnaiva bhasate, abhasata, you, because it is in the past tense, kvasi gataha, kva gataha asi, where are you now? Kva vayam, where are we? We are nowhere near you, we are not there near you, we are not able to reach you. Tavaiva ete, we are all, we belong to you and you are not present here. This is the meter in which it is dodhakam is the meter. It's the meaning of that shloka is very simple. Nothing is the problem. So dodhaka vrittam idam bha bhat gau. So bha gana, bha and bha. Three bha ganas are there, and then two guru have to be there. Guru letters have to be there. Again, if you look at this vrittam also here, deva, it is actually the last letter is a laghu and it has become a padanta laghu, so it has taken the guru bhava. So, but this is supposed to be a hasya rasa vyanjakam vrittam. What are all the, there are many vrittams which are karuna rasam, like shakwari, mandakranta. Mandakranta is for both karuna rasam and vipralamba shungara. Pushpita agra, these are all, even gatha for that matter. Gatha can be both shringaram and it can be for vipralamba shringaram. It's the most beautiful meter for vipralamba shringaram. Mandakrantam is the entire megasandesham. If you look at it, it is made in mandakranta meter. And that can be used for karuna rasam. Shringara, you have prithivi, vasanta tilakam, sragdhara. These are also possible. Shikharini, Veera, for Veeram you have Shikharini, Shardula Vikriditam, Rathodhata is another meter which is also very good for Veera, Adbhuta Krodha, Bhayanaka also. So the rest, whatever is said for Veeram can go for Raudram also. You can have the rest and all, you have to look at the Artham and the way it goes. See, you're talking of Bhakti Rasam, and for Bhakti, you can give Shartula Vikriditam or you can make shlokas in Ratodhata or anything. Depends on who the person is being described and what the artham is being described. So for that, you should look at, you can't take Ratodhata and put it for a Karuna Rasam. It won't fit because the the meter itself has got a rhythm which is like a ratham, which is going like a ratham. Why would you want Karuna Rasam there? No? Mandakratham is more, the way it goes is kaschit kanta viraha guruna swadhika. See, the way itself, every meter has its own way of singing or reciting. So that will give you the rasam very beautifully. This one is more of a hasya rasa pradhanam, which should not be used for the Karuna Rasam, especially when you are talking of a king here who is dead. Okay, so hasya rasa vyanjakam etat vrittam. It's not a hard and fast rule that this vrittam is for this rasa. It is not a hard and fast rule. As the artham goes, as the feel of the meter goes, you have to use it for that particular rasa. Okay. It is Sahridayika Vedyam. Now, next one is Nyunapadam. Let me just check here if I have missed out. No. Okay. Nyunapadam Yatha. Tatha Bhutam Drishtva Nripasadasi Vanchala Tanayam. वने व्याधैः सार्धं सुचिरमुषितं वल्कलधरैः विराटस्यावासे स्थितम् अनुचित आरम्भनिभृतं गुरुः खिन्नेमयि भजति खेदं न अद्यापि कुरुषु. दिस् हि हैज मेन्शन्ड् इट् बिफोर् इन् तृतीय उल्लासं, वेर् दिस् इस् अ उत्तमध्वनिश्लोकः. सो ईवन् द वे मम्मटा आल्सो लुक्स् एट् दोषम् इस् वेरि क्लियर् बै हिम् टेकिङ्ग् दिस् एक्साम्पल्, where he quotes this as a kaku akshiptam dhvanishlokam in tritiyollasam, where he starts off with artha vyanjakata vaktru bodhavya kakunam vaishishtyanam. So there he says, because of kaku, here the shloka is a dhvanishlokam, whereas here he says he takes this as an example for nyunapadam, where there is a lesser number than the words that, you know, have to be used, are all words are not present here. Now the context here is Yudhishthira is I think it is the Vanamasam, where Yudhishthira, Sahadeva, Bhima and all of them are talking here. So I think Sahadeva says Arya kadachit khidyate guruhu. So, is it even possible for Yudhishthira to feel upset about anything or disappointed in someone? So Bhima says, Guruhu kim khedam janati, khedam api janati. Does he even know to feel upset or disappointed with the situation? See, he has witnessed so many happenings in our lives, and yet he has not felt any such disappointment or anger towards anybody. Tatha bhutam panchala tanayam nripa sadasi drishtva. Tatha bhutam. Enna ellame arthantara sankramitamma. So nripa sadasi in the darbar of the kings. So tatha bhutam panchalatanayam drishtva. Now your dharmapatni, one thing. The other thing is she is also a panchalatanaya. She is the daughter of Drupada. Tadrishim draupadim drishtva tatha drishtva tatha bhutam. Whatever atyahitam that Dushasana did in front of the entire sabha, even after seeing that, he has not, nothing has happened there. You know, he did not feel any disappointment or upset or anger because of that. Vane vyadhai sardham suchiram ushitam valkaladharaihi. So vane, in the forest after that, vyadhai sardham along with hunters, Suchiram Ushitam, for a long time we it was that is we stayed. It is in the passive voice, so you have to use it as Valkala Dharaihi Asmabhihi Ushitam. Vayam avasanna avasama. So instead of that you say Valkara Dharaihi Asmabhihi Ushitam. That Asmabhihi is absent. That is a Nyunapadam here. That is the dosham. So in the forest we lived. Residing in the forest along with the hunters, we were also wearing bark garments at that point of time. So Valkala Dharaihi, after that Viratasya Avase, during the Ajnatavasam, Viratasya Avase in the city of Virata, in secrecy we were all doing anuchita, inappropriate work. Stitam anuchita arambha nibhritam stitam asmabhihi. Asmabhihi, again, further, we were also staying in that Viratasya Avase, in his Nagaram. Anuchita, doing an inappropriate Arambha work. Nibhritam, in secrecy. Tadrisham Asmabhihi Sthitam Cha Drishtva. After seeing all these three situations, Guruhu, Ittam Khinne Mai Eva Khedam Karoti Khedam Bhajati. I am already wounded by all these things after seeing Draupadi and being in the forest and then staying in for a Kshatriya person like Sahadeva and Nakula to take care of cows and horses. It must have been for Tathavi. In C, so I'm not like the software engineers who just drop their job and take up whatever they want to do. I'm pursuing my hobby as a professional career. That is not what they did. They had to do it in secrecy without the knowledge of the Kauravas. So Anuchita Arambha Nibhritam. Hence, Bhima says he is Khinne Mai. I'm already wounded. Guruhu Khinne Mai Eva Khedam Bhajati. He is only disappointed in my talk. Na adhyapi kurushu. He is not disappointed with the way Kauravas have behaved. He is not angry at them. He is not showing his temper there. But he is showing his temper to me. In this, he points out the dosham by saying that asmabihi is a word that has to have been there. Asmabihi ushitam. Asmabihi nibhritam sthitam. And itham khinne mayi. Itham is purvokta ritya khinne mayi bhajati. So both those words are missing. Why he points out this is, if you don't know the context, then it is a dosham. You can avoid this dosham. That is what he is trying to say here. Even, see, it's very easy to understand the words asmabihi and itham. You don't need those. And the way the mental situation in which Bhima is, he would not be thinking of substituting words like these. In fact, one of the vyakhyatas say, there is no dosham in this. In fact, if Bhima were to use all these words, then that is where the dosha is. He is in that state of mind where he cannot think cogently. He can only, that reveals his disappointment even more than anything else. The anger and that sadness, the grief that is there, the self-pity that is there in Bhima is very beautifully reflected in this. Otherwise, it doesn't, you don't need so many words. That's what it is. Okay, so to point out that this can be a dosha, he is just pointing it out. That's all. You don't need to take it as this shlokam is completely dosha yuktam and it has to be removed from the entire kavyam. That's not the idea of any dosha shloka, dosha yuktam shloka. Okay, so the next is, we are not going to artha doshas as yet. Let me take the textbook now. Atra asmabihi iti khinne ityasmat purvam itham iti cha. Next is adhika padam. We saw nyuna padam where there is he could have प्रतिमल्ल अस्तम अस्तमय उदयः. हेलो. प्रतिमल्ल, यु आर एबल टु हियर?
Yeah, in the middle it's getting disconnected many times, Akka. This is like the third time. I don't know why. Today the video quality is not great.
Okay. Adhikapadam स्फटिकाकृति निर्मलः प्रकामं प्रति संक्रांत निशात शास्त्र तत्त्वः अविरुद्ध समन्वितोक्ति युक्तिः प्रतिमल्ल अस्तमय उदयः स कोऽपि. This is a description of a king, and he is not a king, vidushah varnanam, vidwan. It's about a vidwan whose akriti, his form is nirmalaha. It is very pure, like the spatika akriti nirmalaha. Spatika akriti he eva nirmalaha. Just like how the spatikam is very nirmalam, in the same way he is also very pure. Pure means here you should take it as ragadvesha rahitaha tasmat nirmalaha. So spatikasya akritih eva akritih tadrisha nirmala akritih yasya saha. So spatika akriti nirmalaha prakamam, he is indeed prati sankranta nishata shastra tattva. Because he is pure and ragadvesha rahitaha saha tasmat shastra tattvam, whatever the shastra the reasoning, knowledge that is there, which is difficult, nishata, tikshnam or durgraham, any shastram which is durgraham, it easily reflects in his mind. Pratisankrantam, if you take the spatikam, spatikam actually takes the reflection of anything that is kept nearby. If you keep a japakuspam beside it, like a hibiscus flower or a rose flower, if it is red in color, the spatikam will also reflect that. And the spatikam will show it as, you will think it is a red spatikam. So that's why it varies according to the skin color also. It depends on who wears it. So the same way here also, if the mind of a vidwan is like a spatikam, so it very clearly can reflect the knowledge that is there in the shastras. Whatever he reads is very beautifully translates in his mind. He doesn't have to make such a great effort. So prati sankranta nishata shastra tattva, nishata tikshna athava durgraha shastrani tesham tattvani. So shastrasya tattvam easily prati sankrantam, it is pratibimbitam asti yasya hridaye aviruddha samanvita ukti yuktihi. Now because he has a pure form which is devoid of any raga dvesha, and the shastra tattvam is very easily reflected, the words that come out of his mouth are also aviruddha samanvita ukti yukti. Aviruddha, there no inconsistency in his speech. Viruddham is inconsistency, aviruddham is a consistent speech. Samanvitam and samanvita ukti, well reasoned speech. Ukti is his yuktayaha, all his yukti, the ideas that he uses to put forth, the words that he uses to put forth his ideas are all well reasoned out and consistent. So samanvita, samyak anvitam anvayena yuktam, samyak anvitam, paraspara anvayaha vartate shabdanam arthanam cha. So tadrisha uktihi yasya aviruddha samanvita ukti yuktihi. Because of that, what happens in a vakyartha sadas? Pratimalla astamaya udayaha. Pratimalla, prativadi is there, he can easily defeat the opposition. So pratimalla astamaya udayaha, and he causes the astamanam of pratimalla, of the prativadi, and his own udaya. He also emerges victorious by defeating the pratimalla. Okay, very very nice shlokam. I like this. The problem word again, atra akriti shabdaha, Spatika Nirmalaha itself is enough to convey the meaning of Spatika, Spatikasya Akritihi Yatha Vartate Tatha Nirmalaha Ayam, Nirmala Swabhava Ayam. Iti. Atra Spatika Akritihi Ityapi Vaktum Anavashyam. So not necessary to mention that, you know, the form of Spatika, which is Nirmala, the very idea of Spatikam gives rise to Nirmalatva. That is enough. Okay. Next is Yathava. Now this one is Samasagatam. Adhikapadam Samasagatam, where inside the Samasa there are three words, and in that one word is an extra. It is redundant. It is not at all necessary. Now the next shloka he takes up is Idam Anuchitam Akramaha. This is just Padagatam or Asamasagatam. So Idam Anuchitam Akramascha Pumsam Yadiha Jaraswapi Manmathaha Vikaraha Yadapicha Nakritam Nitambini Nam Stanapatana Avadhi Jivitam Ratamba. Here it's talking about how this asha is there in our minds, even at a very late stage in our life, when we should be looking at bhakti or dharma, or how to improve our, you know, how to get more punyam in our life so that our next life can be better. But he says people are, the manmatha vikara is so strong in our mind that we still are unable to let go of those feelings in our mind. So idam anuchitam akramaha pumsam yadiha pumsam for men. So he points out for both men and for women. Nitambini namcha for both women. So for men, how it is yadi iha in this world iha manmatha vikaraha jarasu api. Manmatha's the kama the affairs of manmatha or the vikaras of manmatha are present for men, pumsam, jarasu api, even in old age it is present. That is idam tu anuchitam. It is inappropriate and akramaha. It is not, you know, shastra viruddham asti, because shaishave abhyastha vidyanam yavvane vishayeshinam vardhake munivrittinam yogenante natyacha. It's an example of how people should be. Vardhake munivrittinam vriddhatvam yada vartate tada munihi iva acharanam kartavya. It's not dharma parama arkanam. Anyway, you can't do that. It's that asha angam galitam palitam mundam dasana vihinam jatam tundam vriddho yati grihitva dantam tadapina munchati asha pindam. Shankara has very beautifully said that. You also have to look at Vairageshadakam for this. Angam galitam. Your body is completely gone. It's lost its shakti. Palitam mundam. That's fine. You know, white hair. People are even gray immaturely nowadays, even at 20. So that's okay. Palitam mundam. Dashana vihinam. You don't have any teeth. Jatam tundam. Your body has become like that. Vriddho yati grihitva dandam. Is not able to walk on his own and he needs the help of a cane. Tadapi na munchati asha pindam. You want to go and visit so many places, you want to go see so many things that you are willing to grab even a cane and totter around the whole wide world and see things. That asha has got such a tough grip on our soul. So, jarasu api, even in old age, pumsam for men, manmatha vikaraha, anuchitam idam, yat manmatha vikaraha. The fact that there are manmatha vikara even in this old age for men, it is anuchitam, it's inappropriate, and akramaha shastra viruddham cha. Yadapi nitambini naam stanapatana avadhi ratam na kritam tat. Even the other thing for women and for women, nitambini naam, how is it? Life, jivitam ratam va, jivitam life, the verb for life, for living, no? That and ratam, ratam is enjoyment. So it is rati. That sexual enjoyment also, that is na kritam, it was not done even when stana patana avadhi. Stanapatana Avadhi is even when your physical appearance, physical beauty is lost, even at that time that asha for enjoyment was not stopped. Na kritam iti idam anuchitam akramascha. You go and connect it back with that. Now, atra kritam iti adhikam padam. Why he says kritam is adhikam padam? You don't need iti na kritam becomes an explanatory part for this. Whereas for the first line, it is idam anuchitam akramaha. That itself will satisfy for the second line also. He actually suggests another yadapicha na kurangalochananam stanapatana avadhi jivitam ratamva. That would have satisfied. Then you can connect it with idam anuchitam akramaha cha. Yadapi, the fact that kurangalochananam stanapatana avadhi jivitam ratamva asti tat idam uchitam anuchitam akramaha cha. Then it would connect to that. You don't, that extra is na kritam ityetat, that becomes an extra. Or kritam becomes an extra. Okay. Kritam pratyuta prakrama bhangam avahati. He points out another dosha here called prakrama bhangaha, where you, whatever kramam, whatever process is followed in the first half, this the same process should be followed in the second half also. So, for example, in that prakrama bhanga, I think you would remember in Shakuntala, sarasajam anuviddham shaivalenaapi ramyam malinamapi himamshor lakshma lakshmin tanoti iyam adhika manojnya. See, the prakrama is not followed in the first and second. The way in which the first line is said, like vidya dadati vinayam vinayadyati patratam, if everything has to follow a process which is there, if it just changes, then it is not it is a dosha, it is considered as a dosha. So here also, in the same way, if you look at that, idam anuchitam akramaha is there, and manmataha vikaraha bhavanti ityetat. Whereas in the second line, you will find yadapichan akritam, that it becomes an extra and it doesn't follow the pattern in which the first line is given. So that is why he says it is prakrama bhangam avahati. Tathacha yadapichana kurangalochananam iti paathe nirakanksha eva pratitihi. In that there is no akanksha for kritam. And there is an understanding, pratitihi, jnanam bhavati, akanksha. Kritam iti padasya akanksham vinayeva jnanam bhavati. It fits with idam anuchitam and akramaha. We don't need that word kritam here. Huh? Purirda? I hope you understand. We'll go to the next one. Next is kathita padam. Adhi karatala talpam. When you split this word, it's very easy to say adhika tarala, adhika tara karatala. You will miss out that. So adhi karatala talpam. Split it like that. Kalpita swapalila parimilana nimilat pandima gandapali sutanu kathaya kasya vyanjayati anjasayeva smara narapati lilaya Leela Yavarajya Abhishekam. Okay. Some girl is very upset, or she's just thinking about the Nayaka, and she's not upset, you can say she's thinking about him. So when thinking, it's very natural that if you're lost in your own thoughts, you're going to have your hand like this in your cheeks, and you're going to keep thinking about that person. And that's the description here in this shloka. Adhi karatala talpam. Karatalam meva talpam asti. It is the softest pillow that you can find in the whole wide world. So adhi karatala talpam is an avyayi bhava samasa. The meaning of it is karatala talpe. Saptamyarthe adhi. So the meaning of that is only in saptami. And on the hand, which is the bed, karatalam eva talpam tasmin, she is keeping her gandapali. So karatala talpe gandapali nikshipta kathaya. Hey sutanu, your cheeks are placed on your hand, which is like a bed. கல்பித ஸ்வாப லீலா பரிமிளன நினீலது பாண்டிமா. Now, you are in Virahavastha, so there is a paleness on your cheeks, and that paleness is Ninilati. It's completely covered by Parimilanam, because of the Melanam with your cheeks and your Karatalam, your Hastapadam, Hasta Pradesha, Parimilanathu. Now, why is it joined there? Kalpita Swapalila, you are making a show of sleeping. It's as if you are trying to sleep. So kalpita swapa swapam sleeping. Nidra leela parimilana, because of that it is joined. Tasmat ganda pradeshe ya pandima pandu varnam vartate tam nimilati. You're covering that varnam with your hands. Sutanu, now she's asking, who is there, who is the lord of your thoughts? Huh? So there should be somebody whom you're thinking about. Maybe a Sakhi is asking the Naika, and is saying, who is there in your thoughts? So kasya abhishekam vyanjayati. Now it is very clear from your posture that you are thinking about some Nayaka, and that Nayaka definitely must be in your mind. Let's say he is having a Yuvaraja Abhishekam in your mind and you are looking at that. So for the Yuvaraja Abhishekam to happen for that Nayaka, there should be a Simhasanam. The Simhasanam is Manmatha Leela. So Manmatha Leela ha eva Simhasanam. Manmatha is the Narapati. So if there is a Yuvaraja Abhishekam being happened, then there should be a Raja there, for whom the Yuvaraja is the Naika. So the Raja here is Smara, Manmatha. So Smara Narapati, Manmathaha Yeva Narapatihi Yatra, Tasya Leelaha, Achumbanadi Leelaha, Te Yeva, you can, he doesn't mention here, that is the Yuvarajyam. That is the Yuvarajatvam. And Tatra Abhishekam, Kasya Abhishekam Yanjayati. So you are placing your Nayaka on the Yuvaraja position. That Yuvaraja position is actually the, say, for a king, the Yuvaraja is the person who oversees all the affairs. The king just sits on the throne. It's the Yuvaraja who oversees everything. So here, Manmatha is like the king who is older. So he cannot compare himself to the Nayaka who is there, who is going to be coronated as the Yuvaraja, as the prince. So since the Nayaka is the prince and Manmatha is described as the Narapati, Smara Narapatehe Leelaha Eva Yavvarajyattvam Tatra Abhishekam Kasya Karoti Kasya Vyanjayati. Anjasa means quickly. Shigram, you're quickly doing some coronation ritual in your mind for some Nayaka. And who is he? She's asking. So here she's describing Manmatha. So it's actually Vyatireka Alankaram, where it's an Alankara Dhani. So Manmatha is, the Nayaka is better than the Manmatha. She is trying to say that here. So Adhikara Talpam Kalpita Swapalila. Here Kathita Padam is, the word has been said already. The word Leela has been used twice. It shows immediately that poet does not know any other synonym for Leela. He can use Krida. Once he could have used Kalpita Swapa Krida, but he wanted to use for Anuprasam, so he has said Kalpita Swapa Leela Parimilana Nimilat. Smara Narapati Krida, there the meter will be gone if he uses Krida. So, in other words, it just shows that the Kavi is not creative enough, or he doesn't have the capability to use different words to create that without any dosham. The repetition of the word Leela in the first line, Prathama Pade, Chaturtha Pade cha Leela Padasya idu Anuvritti. That is why it is called Kathita Padam, that which has already been said. Adhi Karatala Talpam Kalpita Swapa Leela Parimilana Nimilat Pandima Gandapali Sudanu Kathaya Kasya Vyanjaya Tyanjasaiva Smara Narapati Leela Yavarajya Abhishekam. Next is Patat Prakarsham. Oh, it's already 9:55. I'll stop with this. We'll continue next class. We'll have class on Thursday, and after that we won't have class for about three classes. Okay. Namaste.